Change detection is the most underrated and important topic inside Angular, and 90% of Angular developers don't understand this topic completely. This is why their application, and probably yours, is 20 times slower than it can be. So let's fix that. So here I have a simple Angular application with just two components. As you can see here, we rendered the list of our to-dos, and here inside to-do folder I have two components, to-do for the single component and to-dos for our list. As you can see here, to-dos is just an array of our object, and here inside HTML we have ng for loop where we are rendering our additional component to-do, and here is this component. Nothing here, just a div with the text, and here we have just an input with to-do props, and it is our to-do interface. And the first question that all Angular developers are asking, how we can know how many times our component rendered? If you don't know, inside React, we can simply write a console log inside our component, and then we will see this console log every single time when our component is being rendered. This is extremely simple, but we can't do like this inside Angular because we don't have a functional components, but we have classes. So actually, normally I would expect some callback after our rendering is happening. But actually there is an easier way. What we want to do, we want to create additional function which will just return some value. For example, here let's create inside our to-do component a function checkRender. And this function will return for us Boolean. And I don't want to do anything inside, just write console log, and here will be our checkRender message, and I just return here true. Which means our function does not do anything, but we will call it inside our HTML. So let's write here one more div and call inside this checkRender. So I will write here checkRender, so we see what is it about. And here is our checkRender function, and we need to call it. As you can see now, I'm reloading the page, and here we see checkRender true, but for us most importantly is console log here. Now we know how many times our component to-do is being rendered. As you can see, 3 here and 3 here, which means our component is being rendered 6 times. And actually, it is already not what we expected. As you can see, we have just 3 components, so here we need to see 3 renders. Why we have 6 renders here? To understand this, you must understand how change detection is working inside Angular. And actually, in all frontend frameworks, it is working the same. You have a state, like some global object inside JavaScript, and you have a DOM representation of this state. So actually, this is a state of our application inside a framework. So what is happening with every our change, for example, we clicked on button, Angular is going from our top component, our root component, to our deeply nested child components. And actually it goes through the whole tree and checks if all values and all bindings inside our components are being changed. For example, as you can see here inside to-do, we have 2 bindings, one for text here and one for a function. And actually for every component, Angular inside creates a special view. So we have one-to-one relation between our component and Angular internal view. And inside this view, Angular stores all bindings with old values and current values. Which means Angular is going through all components and checking if the bindings are changed from the old value to the new value. And if they are changed, then Angular re-renders it inside DOM tree. And here is a super important point. Angular change detection cycle is synchronous, which means it takes time for Angular to go from the top component to the bottom component. But also, it's important to remember that Angular is doing this check twice and not once in development mode. And this is exactly why we see here on the screen twice our rendering of components. Because first of all, Angular is doing the first check and then it ensures that everything is staying the same and basically is doing the same check again. And it is extremely important because this second check is happening later, which means Angular compares once again if values are not changed. And actually, if you are using, for example, time now inside your template, then you will get an error. Expression changed after it is being checked. And actually, it is the most confusing error that people don't understand inside Angular. Actually, this error simply means that between Angular does the first check and the second check, your values were changed. And actually, it is exactly the problem and you need to fix it. And inside production application, Angular doesn't do the second check, which means it can't ensure that your values were not changed. It is only for development purpose. So now you know that it's not bad that we see it here 6 times, and this is completely normal for development. But we have another things that are not normal. For this, let's jump to the top component in our to-dos and add here on the bottom one more div with input inside. So I simply want here to create input type text, and here I want to add keyUp event. So here let's name it, for example, change text. And here we are providing inside our $event dot target dot value. Now let's create this function change text inside our to-dos here on the bottom. I won't do anything inside but simply write console log change text. Now let's see what problem do we have. I will simply reload our page, and as you can see here we have our input. And now I'm typing something here, and as you can see in our console log, with each letter that I'm typing, we're getting again our console log check render, which actually means we're not doing anything with our to-dos, but we re-render the whole tree. We're doing a change, and Angular is simply going through all our components again and checking every single property. And Angular doesn't care by default if our change is related to other component or not. How we can fix that? By using change detection strategy. This is why I want to jump back inside our to-do component, and here inside our component declaration, we can add new property change detection. And by default, it is change detection strategy dot default, and we can change it to on push. And actually on push change detection is happening not that often as our default strategy. Let's check this out. I'm reloading the page. As you can see, we still have check render, but now it is only 3 times, and now I'm typing something inside our input, and as you can see, we're not getting check render again, but we simply see only our console log change text, which means now it is working correctly. The question is only what we did. So actually what onPush is doing inside Angular, it simply takes this component outside of Angular change detection cycle, which means Angular simply doesn't check this component if we don't have several specific cases. And the most popular case when Angular will re-render this component is when we are changing our input. As you can see here, we have an input to-do, which means if we change it outside, then Angular will trigger rendering of our component. Let's check this out, because here we also have a problem. I will go outside to our to-dos, and as you can see, we have an array. Now I just want to create a new button here on the bottom, and inside I want to change the first element of this array. So here let's create our button with onClick event, and let's say here change array function. And we don't need any parameters, and I will name it change array. Now let's create this change array function, but I also want to remove inside our change text the value because we are not using it at all, and it was only to check our render. Now let's jump back inside our to-dos file and create here a new function, and let's name it change array, and inside we want to change directly our element inside these to-dos. So here we can write this to-dos first element, and here we want to change text, and I will assign here foo. And after this I want to console log our this.todos. Now let's check if it's working. I'm reloading the page and hitting change, and nothing is happening. So actually even my console log is not there. Let's check HTML, and here I already see my mistake. It's not onClick but just a click. I'm reloading the page, hitting change, but as you can see our console log is there, and we can see that our first object was changed and here is text, but our check render is not happening, and as you can see our first to-do was not rendering. Why it is happening? Because actually Angular is comparing all inputs which are arrays and objects, like in JavaScript by reference, which actually means this code is not changing the reference. Because actually a reference is our first object, and here we simply change the property of the same object, and this object is still referencing the same object inside memory, which means this code is wrong because it will never trigger our change of the input. So what we can do instead, I will comment this code and we must create here a new object. Then it will be fine. This is why here I want to write this to-do 0 and I want to assign inside a new object and I will spread here this to-do 0. So I take all properties of the first element and now here I want to overwrite text equals foo. And obviously this code is more difficult to read, but it will work correctly because we are creating here a new object. I'm reloading the page, I'm hitting here change array, and as you can see now it is working. We have here check render, this is our rendering of the component, and you can see on the screen that our foo is changed. Which actually means it is completely possible to use our own push with inputs and it is working out of the box. We simply have here change detection on push and it will still be re-rendered, so it's not like it is completely stale when our input is being changed. The second case that is interested for us is if we can re-render our component from inside when some event is happening. For example, can we change the text of our to-do here inside our component? And for this I want to create a new div here and inside a button. So we want to create a button that will change our text. So here let's add a button and here I will close a button and let's name it change text. And inside I want to add here click event. And let's name this function changeText. And I will just call it with round brackets because it's simply for debugging. Now let's jump to our TS file and here create this function changeText. And what we want to do inside, we want to change our this dot todo props dot text. And here I want to assign changed from inside. So actually we just created a button to check if events inside our component will trigger the re-rendering of the component when we are using on push. Let's reload our page. As you can see we have change text button inside every component and I'm hitting here change text and we successfully re-rendered our component and as you can see inside console we have our check render, which means on push is working completely fine when we are triggering our events from inside of our component. And the last case that is super important because we are using streams a lot is how on push is working with streams. And as you can see here near my components, I have a service to do service. And I have just a single behavior subject inside and this is our stream filter with a string all inside. And now we want to use this stream inside our to do component. This is why I am jumping back inside our to-do component and here first of all we need to inject our to-do service. This is why here will be constructor, private and here let's name it to-do's service and we want to inject here our to-do service. Now inside our constructor we can assign our stream. So here I want to create a variable $filter and here is to-do service.filter. And we also need to create this property inside our component. So here let's create filter property and it is our observable and here we are passing inside string because we know the value of the filter is a string. Now let's render this filter inside HTML. So I'm jumping inside our HTML file. Let's add here one more div and write here filter and then the value. And I'm using here filter with dollar and I'm using here async pipe. And if you don't remember, async pipe is how we are working inside Angular with streams. Angular will simply subscribe for the value from this filter and render it here. Let's check this out, I'm reloading the page. As you can see, filter all is rendered here, which means everything is working. This is fine, but the question is if we can change the filter. Because the problem here that our observable is actually an object, which means filter is an object and probably Angular won't change this object and re-render our component. And then it won't all work together. This is why we need to check it and for this I want to create a new method changeFilter and it will return void as always. And here what I want to do, I want to write this dot to do service and directly here I have access to our filter stream and I want to change it by using next. For example, to value active. Now we need to write this change filter button inside our to-do. So I will simply copy paste this button change text and let's name it change filter. And here the text will be change filter. Let's check if it's working. I'm reloading the page. We have here change filter. As you can see, we have here all. We're hitting change filter and bam, our component was re-rendered. And as you can see, we have three rendering because we subscribed to this change in every single component. And the question is why it is working at all if it is an object, and we know that Angular can't really compare objects without change. And actually it is because we are using this async pipe inside HTML. This async pipe is coming from Angular, and Angular knows, okay, I need to render component when stream is being changed. This is why you can completely safely use ng-rex or maybe just plain rx.js or any streams that you want, because when you are using a sync pipe, even with on-push strategy, Angular will re-render your component correctly. So here is a conclusion. On-push change detection strategy is a must if you want to do a fast-performant Angular application. And also, if you are interested to learn 5 most popular Angular mistakes, make sure to check this video.